Thank you, Mr. Chairman, and thank you both for your service. General Perna, what's the normal timeline to develop a vaccine these days?
Senator, as I understand it, somewhere between 5 and 10 years.
Thanks. And I know your expertise is more in the logistics side of things, but this task that and this goal that we have set that within possibly a year of this virus being unleashed on us, that we would put all of the brain power, all the innovation, all the strength and leadership of our government agencies, our industry, our researchers together in order to develop this vaccine for the American people in warp speed. I mean, this is a pretty Herculean task, but really shows the best of America coming together. Don't you agree?
100%.
It's unprecedented. And I think, you know, as we have snarky, you know, cynics out there that are trying to take pot shots at any little effort. I mean, this is us really reaching for the stars in order to defeat this virus and protect the American people. And it comes with, you know, challenges for sure, but we've got to give all we have. So I really appreciate your leadership in this very important endeavor. One thing that the coronavirus has awakened us to is our reliance on our adversary, Communist China, for pharmaceuticals, for our PPE, and for many other elements of our supply chain. So as we are increasing the manufacturing capability in parallel to the testing here, for Operation Warp Speed, both for the vaccine and for the potential treatments. Can you talk about whether you are holistically looking at the industrial base of America and the supply chain holistically for not just these treatments and vaccines, but really bringing that home? We saw with testing, it wasn't just developing the test, for example. Then it was about, we don't have the swabs here. We don't have the transport fluid and the vials and the reagent. And so there's all elements of this supply chain for these treatments and this vaccine. So is your team looking into bringing home the supply chain for all elements of this effort back to America and away from our adversary, China?
Senator, my responsibilities, if confirmed on the team, would not be about corralling all the supply chain and bringing it back to America, as you articulated. It would be focused primarily to ensure that we are able to enable manufacturing and then delivery and administration. So buying forward to meet that requirement.
But when you say manufacturing, what I'm getting at is not just manufacturing of the vaccine. If we're going to be successful here with these treatments and the vaccine, we need everything that goes with it, the vials, the syringes, all that. So are they holistically looking at the manufacturing of all of it is what I'm asking.
Senator, they are. I just specified that my responsibility is not about enabling the country to have all that capability. It's about the execution to the vaccine. It's a mild, I just wanted to say. Oh.
Okay, no, I appreciate that. But as part of the leadership team, I just want to make sure that that is part of the focus. So it's not just manufacturing the vaccine, but everything we need in order to deliver it, as well as the treatments. Are you aware, I mean, there are ongoing efforts on the same topic of the defense industrial, or the domestic industrial base, not defense industrial base for medical supplies and pharmaceuticals. The Defense Production Act is being used for some of that. Do you know how Project Warp Speed might be coordinating and leveraging with these existing efforts?
So absolutely do know that they're involved, that they're being executed. And as far as Operational Warp Speed, I have direct access to the Defense Planning Act through Secretary Azar or Secretary Esper.
Okay, great. Thank you. I appreciate it. General Hoganson, the National Guard has been absolutely vital to help Arizona, and they still are as we confront and we deal with this pandemic. I personally volunteered at various food banks and worked alongside them. And I'm just so proud of the men and women of the Guard and them stepping up to do so many different things in order to be able to help Arizona in this very challenging time. Just yesterday, Governor Ducey announced that 300 more Arizona Guardsmen will be involved in contact tracing as well in Arizona. So we couldn't be getting through this time without the men and women of the Arizona Guard. Again, I'm so proud of them. Is there anything else that you need in order for our guardsmen and women to be able to conduct the various missions that they're being asked to by the governors to get us through this challenge?
Senator, not at this time. We just greatly appreciate your continued support and that of the committee.
Fantastic. I appreciate it. All right. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you, gentlemen, for your service.
Thank you, Senator McSally. Senator Jones.